Our journey now takes us back in time. Much of programming began for the sole purpose of processing data. That's why in the early days, programming was sometimes referred to as data processing. Each of these large machines is a disk drive that could store up to 5 megabytes of data. We've come a long way since then, as most pocket-sized phones now have thousands of times more storage. Today, most applications still process data. Anything we put into an application, like our expense report or social media post, is data. Most types of role-playing and adventure games, even our online pet cafe, involve collecting stuff. What you have, how many you have, and what it does. In our example, we want to track each user's virtual pets. And information that comes out of an application, like our Facebook or Twitter feed, or our application's messages, is also data. As developers, we often work with two kinds of data. Local data, which is defined and used only within the program, and external data, which is defined and stored somewhere outside of the program, hence the name. For example, external data may reside on another computer somewhere, so it can be shared between programs and users. Let's talk about local data first. Each piece of local data that our application works with is stored in a variable. A variable has 3 characteristics. A name, so our instructions can refer to that data, a value, which is the piece of data itself, and a data type, which is the kind of that data. For example, for our pet cafe, we ask the user for the number of pets they want. We give the variable a name, such as number of pets. It may have a value of 3, and the data type is a number, meaning that the number of pets must always be a number. We give each variable a unique name so the program can keep track of what data is in which variable. A variable value is, well, variable, meaning its value can change as the instructions run. So our number of pets can be 3 now, but if the user wants more pets, it can later be 5. In most programming languages, the data type constrains the value. If the data type is a number, the variable can only hold a numeric value. Looking again at the instructions for our first iteration of our pet cafe, we would define variables, such as type of pet, to hold the user-entered value, number of pets to hold that user-entered value, message to hold the message the computer displays to the user, and greeting for the pet's greeting. Notice how we name these variables with useful names, but with no spaces. We use capital letters to indicate the start of each appended word. We could just name these variables I or X, but those names don't provide any useful meaning. A variable name should describe the information it represents. This makes the variable easier to understand when reading the code. Variable naming is especially important if anyone else will read your code, even if that someone else is you a few weeks later. To store something in a variable, assigning it a value, we use the equal sign. Here we assign a value of cat. We set the number of pets to 3. The message to display to the user is built from the entered values, and the greeting repeats the appropriate greeting once for each pet. Let's look at another example. Remember our number guessing game? What variables would you define for these instructions? Pause the video now if you want to give it a try. Are you ready for my solution? Here are my variables. Generated number to store the computer's randomly generated number. Current user guess for the user entered guess. And message for the message to display to the user. You win too low or too high. Is that close to what you came up with? It's often said that naming is one of the most difficult challenges of programming. So don't worry if your variable names aren't similar to mine. If the variable name conveys the variable's contents, it's a good name. So, we use a variable to store local data for our program. Our program uses that data to perform its instructions and for display to the user. Each variable has a name describing its contents, a value, which is the data stored in the variable, and a data type, which is the kind of data stored in that variable. Before we move on to external data, let's talk more about data types.